Today we're going to go over my thoughts and first impressions on Godfall, and we're going to start right now. What's up guys, Reckless here, welcome back to another video. Today, I'm going to go over the new PlayStation 5 game, Godfall, and what I really think about the game so far, and help you guys decide if you should get it or not. Warning, this video contains gameplay of Godfall, so if you don't want any spoilers, you have 5 seconds to leave the video, but if you don't care about any spoilers, then continue to watch. Your 5 seconds starts now. Okay, so let's start off with what is Godfall? Well, Godfall is a third-person slasher looter that has RPG elements to it. Think of it like God of War meets Darksiders meets Demon's Souls. It's a very big world in a sense that I haven't really gotten to an invisible wall that wouldn't let me go any further besides the areas that I had to unlock in a story in order to progress. It consists of all melee weapons like long swords, great swords, and dual blades, which technically are like mini swords, spears called pole arms, and warhammers. Think of it like this. The bigger the weapon, the slower it is to handle, and the more damage it does. But the smaller the weapon, the faster it is, and the less damage that it does. Even though it is not an actual weapon, you can use your shield to damage enemies. And if you haven't realized what all this means, in short, there are no guns. You start off Godfall like most action games with the tutorial, from which was more like a mini mission that actually gave you a feel for the game, rather than the usual boring, press this button to do this kind of thing kind of tutorials. I mean, yeah, you still did that, but it wasn't boring and you got right into the fights. Once the tutorial is complete, then you can join with one or two of your friends. Sorry, there is no matchmaking as of this video, but I'm not saying that it isn't or is coming to the game either. There is no actual jump on command button, and it's more so that you get to a ledge and you press circle to jump across to the other side type of mechanics. I mean, you got a lot of heavy armor on, so I get it. The controls are a little weird at first when you're so used to having a melee button as one of your face buttons and not a trigger. The fighting mechanics aren't that slow, even when you are actually using a weapon like the Warhammer, and it's terribly well balanced. However, if you think that you are just going to slash your way through the campaign easily, you are terribly wrong. You need to go ahead and think on how you are going to attack enemies, because not every enemy is the same. You need to use your combos and parry in a very unique fashion, otherwise you will die. But if you need a little more time getting used to the fighting mechanics, there is a little room in the Seventh Sanctum, which is your main hub for starting missions, that you can practice in against an AI that does fight you back. The AI's health pool is very low. When you use the touchpad, you open your UI. At first, it can be a little overwhelming, but as soon as you navigate around a little, with time, you will get the hang of it. On the top, you have 7 tabs. Equipment, armory, skills, resources, social, codex, and merits. Equipment shows your character on the left with your gear and augments in the middle. Your gear shows what valor plate, which is your armor that you have on, weapons, amulet, charm, rings, stone, and banner. Augments show your augment power usage, which you open later on. And on the very far right is your attributes, which can be changed with any gear, items, or augments that you equip. Now, I won't be getting too much into everything in this video, but I definitely will be saving that for a future video. Armory shows all of the things that is in your inventory, and I will say this. Do not enhance gear in the beginning of the game because you will be getting stronger gear towards the end game. And then it'll kind of be like wasted materials. All gear with the same name has the same base description of what it actually does, but when enhanced, that item, weapon, or armor can have different stats. It's nice to switch from your favorite sword with the fire element to the same kind of sword with a different element or does critical damage. The salvage mechanic allows you to delete unwanted items, but it can be a little difficult to use sometimes. For example, in the equipment tab, when salvaging your gear that is not equipped, sometimes the game won't allow you to delete the item and you would have to go to the Armory tab in order to delete it. This is a small issue, but can be very frustrating when you are trying to do things fast. Also, some weapons have a lock on them, and I don't know if it's possible to unlock them in order to delete them, but at this time, we can't. Hopefully, Counterplay Games can patch this, so we will be able to delete those unwanted pieces of gear. Skills is where you get to tailor your character to your liking, and I love the skill tree in Godfall. You start off at one of the four corners for your first skill, but after your first skill, you can either branch out from there, or you can actually go to one of the other corners. When putting your first skill in, I highly suggest that you use that skill on Finesse, which is at the bottom right-hand corner, because this will help you dodge and move around faster while in battle. Every skill in your skill tree has 5 levels, so go crazy with customizing. But if you find yourself at a point where you accidentally put a skill point into a skill by mistake, you can actually clear all of the skills and start over again. This goes for changing skills around as well. There are so many ways to customize your skills, it's ridiculous. Skill and status building will be the focus of many of my other videos to come, so stay tuned. Resources show you all of the crafting resources you have, and you get these throughout the world. Only specific resources can be found in certain areas though, but you will acquire an abundance of infused jasper in the beginning. After your first mission, you will be able to craft 1 of 3 different types of armors. Then, after the first few missions, you will be allowed to enhance items. Enhancing actually upgrades the rarity of that item. The social tab starts a party with your friends. The codex tab has 3 sub-tabs: bestiary, lore, and gameplay. Bestiary keeps a record of all the different enemies you have slain. Lore tells many stories. You find lore in the different parts of the world, and it looks like a little tablet. But be careful, because sometimes they are very hard to find. Gameplay explains what effects, resources, combat, character, and equipment do. Merits are your in-game objectives, and they have 3 ranks: bronze, silver, and gold. After completing a rank, you get the reward for that current rank you are on. So, once you complete bronze, you get the bronze reward, etc., etc., etc. As for the in-game environment, it is vast. There are so many places to go and enemies to fight, even if you just go in one direction. Loot is everywhere, in chests, defeating enemies, destroying pottery, yes, destroying pottery, and you can even find hidden loot in what is called the Spirit Realm. The Spirit Realm are a place where things are hidden beyond the veil of the physical realm. While fighting enemies with one weapon, your secondary weapon builds up a charge, and when it's full and you change to the secondary weapon, it can do massive damage to the enemies around you. Archon Fury is like your super mode, and every different Valor Plate has a different Archon Fury ability. While in Archon Fury, you take no damage, and you get increased damage as well as whatever effects that current armor you have on does. For example, when I activate Archon Fury for the Mesa Valor Plate, I unleash a shockwave that deals 30 earth damage. But while in Archon Fury, I have 90% chance to inflict poison, 100% damage to poison enemies, and all of my attacks deal earth damage. That's insane. Another thing that I actually definitely like about Godfall is that items, abilities, banners, etc. all stack. So, you can be an individual that is specced out to do all fire damage, or you can mix it up like I have. While in Archon Fury, I get all of the earth bonuses, but my sword also does fire damage as well. But there's more. Let's say you and your 2 teammates all have banners that do crit damage. As long as you all place them close to the same area, you get the benefit from all 3 banners, which in turn puts out an insane amount of damage output. Now, as of this video, I haven't gotten too far in the game because I'm still walking around and gaining experience, looking for lore, and pretty much having a little bit of fun with it, because I definitely like this game. I did, however, have a few issues with the game when it was slow or it looked like it was freezing momentarily during intense fight scenes with other friends. And this happened even with the graphics mode in-game favoring performance. I did turn off aim assist, and that is because I hate that in every single game that I play. There's nothing worse than when you're attacking an enemy, you're attacking, and then a different enemy walks past, and now you're actually fighting that new enemy, but the original enemy is still alive, or worse, they even kill you. And I also turned the bloom effect to the lowest setting, which is 2. Bloom is how bright all the LED accents are in game. While bloom does look amazing, it can mess with your eyes when fighting. But other than those little issues, I do like Godfall so far. It doesn't seem like it was rushed at all, and Godfall does show a lot of promise, especially since they're coming out with expansions. And speaking of expansions, as of Godfall's release date, the code for Expansion 1, if you got the Ascended Edition, does not work, and I assume it'll be activated later on. I probably missed a lot of things, but that's okay, because this video is just a first impressions video, and there are a ton of things to go over, from which I will in later videos. In short, if you haven't decided on whether getting Godfall is worth your time and or money, believe me when I say it is. Godfall checks all of the boxes that a slasher looter should, and then some. Also, there are a lot of mixed reviews out there, so I would stay away from those and actually experience the game for yourself. If you have been playing Godfall, let me know what you guys think about it in the comments below, or after watching this video, if you would actually like to play Godfall if you haven't yet. And that, my friends, brings us to the end of the video. I will see you guys in the next one.